Hey everyone, like you, I'm working from home today due to the coronavirus. So I thought I'd make this quick video to show you how you can connect to the SSL VPN using SonicWall. It's a little bit of help for some of our customers out there. You have to excuse some of the background noise I've got going on here, and I might have to pause the video a couple of times. I've got children running around me and my wife's at home. She's trying to work as well. So let's quickly see what we can do. So on the front page of our website, CETSAT.com, we've got a guide at the top and a little statement about what's happening at the moment. But more importantly, we've got some guides here that I've provided, and these guides will be able to help you with your working from home. So quickly going over some of those, we've got just a general homeworking FAQ, some tips and best practices, connecting to a mobile hotspot. So if your home internet isn't quite as good as you'd like it to be, you can connect to your mobile phone. I might do a video about that later today. The CETSAT SonicWall SSL VPN, so we can connect you to the SonicWall SSL VPN. We're on a Windows 10 machine here, and that's what we're going to do in a minute. And then how to connect to RDP if you're a company that uses RDP as well. So this guide should have been sent out to you by your employer, or you would have had it shared out to you from CETSAT. The version specifically for your company will have your server address here. If it doesn't and you're using this generic one, like it says here, get in contact with us. If you send an email to connect@setsat.com, someone will be able to provide you with those details. If not, your employer should be able to provide you with those details as well. This guide goes into a lot more detail than what we're going to show today. There's detail on here of how to connect from an Android smartphone and tablet, from an Apple device, that's including iPhones and iPads, or from macOS as well. The guide goes into detail and explains how to download SonicWall Mobile Connect. And then a bit later on, it tells you how to set up on a smartphone or tablet. And then it tells you how to set up on a Mac as well. So we're going to follow the guide. We're going to do it in a nice, quick, easy way. So the first thing we need to do, like it says on here, is go to the store. So if we press the start menu, type the word store, we can go to the Microsoft Store. From the Microsoft Store, there's a search button at the top here. If we type the word SonicWall, all one word, press the app that it finds, it'll find an app for us here, and we can simply just press install. It's going to ask for our Windows credentials. We don't really need to give it our Windows credentials. We can just make that go away. It'll download the app, and once the app is installed, that'll change to a little launch button there. So we've now got two ways of adding the VPN to the machine. If we press launch here, it will launch the SonicWall app, and there's a manage button here. If I close that app, I'm going to close the App Store. Let's minimize down Edge as well. If we go to the Start menu and we type the word SonicWall, that'll open the app as well, and there's a Manage button there. Pressing the Manage button, it's going to tell us what it's going to do. It's going to go to our Settings app, and it's going to go straight to the VPN section. If we press OK, it'll open the Settings app straight to that VPN section. So to clarify that, if we press the Start menu and we just type the word Settings, this is the Setting app in Windows 10, and we then type in VPN search because it's quicker than browsing all the way through. This is exactly the same page that it brings us into. There's a button here to add a VPN connection. If you've already got some VPN connections, they'll already be there. There'll be an edit button next to those as well. We're going to add a brand new connection though. So when we add that connection, we're going to change the VPN provider to SonicWall Mobile Connect. That's really important because it has to use the app to connect to our SonicWall. We're going to give the connection a name. We use our company name so we know it's something we know. I'm just going to call this CETSAT SSL VPN because I work for CETSAT. We then put in the address. So the address is the part from the guide that in our generic guide is in red, but you should have an address that's been provided to you either by CETSAT or by your employer. So I'm going to type in my address now. I'm going to press save. So now I've done that, if we click on here and press connect, it will connect to the VPN. And once we connect to the VPN, what that means is our machine on our home connection or our mobile connection is now connected to our works network, and it's almost as if the machine is inside your works building and has access to all the local resources you would normally have when you are at work. It's a secure connection, it's using SSL, it's a security certificate, therefore it's encrypted, and you get all the bonuses of having your firewall present while you're out and about. so you can connect to that over your home connection or over a mobile connection. But once you're connected, you'll be able to access mapped drives, you'll be able to access RDP files, so that's remote desktop, and if you've been set up correctly, you can even remote onto your works machine if that's something that your company has provided for you. So I'm not going to press connect here, because what's more important is I need to show you how to get back to here for tomorrow or for later today after you've disconnected and you want to be able to get in here and connect. So if we close that down here, you can see I'm connected to the internet. You might be on Wi-Fi, so it could be a wireless symbol here. I'm plugged into the network here. If I click on this, we'll see that I'm connected, and we'll see that SSL VPN connection that we made earlier. So this is one way in. We can click on this and it'll come up to exactly the same screen. We can click on here and press connect. The other thing that we can do is if we go to the start menu and we type VPN, it'll take us straight to the VPN. And again, we can click on here and press connect. So the first time we connect, it's going to ask for our login credentials. The login credentials are going to be the same as what you use to log into your Windows machine when you're in the office at work. So I'm going to put in my details now. And I'm going to put in my password. And I'm going to press OK. Now, if you see this, this is simply, it's telling you what's wrong, the incorrect username or password. To retry, press next. Don't worry. And you'll find when you then put in the correct credentials, it will connect, and you are now connected. When you're connected, if we close this down, if we click on here again, we'll see now that the SSL VPN states that it's connected. If we click on here, we can click on here and disconnect. And that's how we would start and end a connected session. Once you're connected, you should then before be able to browse to mapped drives and folder locations. And like we said earlier, if you've got remote desktop or anything internally you need to access, you'll be able to access it. If you need any help during these busy times, if you can send an email to connect@setsat.com, that will raise a ticket. And as soon as one of our engineers is available, they will be in contact with you. When you send that email, if you can please ensure you include your name, the company that you work for, a contact telephone number that we can get hold of you on, and what the issue is that you've got, someone will be able to help you straight away. Thank you very much for watching.